If you are looking for a delicious but simple chicken dish, I have one for you today. This is great for dinner. Silly Kitchen. Today we are making caprese chicken. It is easy. There are about 5 ingredients and then you just throw it in the oven and it's done. Let's go through the ingredient list first. Boneless, skinless chicken breast. Pick your favorite kind of chicken breast. I'm cooking 4 today, but you can do 1, you can do 2, you can do 7, whatever your family needs. You're also going to need some bocconcini. You can use medallions, which I'm using today because I found them at the store. But if you want to buy a fresh mozzarella ball or bocconcini balls, you can use those and slice them as well. Cheese is like life, so whatever cheese you want to use, just go for it. You also need to slice up some tomatoes and then cut them in halves. We also need a little bit of dry oregano, some salt and pepper, olive oil, and that is it. The first thing you want to do is put a few slices into each of your chicken breasts. Don't go all the way through the breast, just a nice diagonal slice twice on each of your chicken breasts. The reason we're doing that is because we're actually going to stuff our tomato and our bocconcini or fresh mozzarella, whatever you're using, into those slices. So you're going to do that, like I said, twice on each of your chicken breasts. We are going to season the chicken breasts with a little bit of salt and pepper. We are also going to drizzle olive oil all over the pan. We also need some dry basil. And I think I said oregano in the opening, but I meant basil, so switch it to basil. Once you have that all ready, you want to preheat your oven to 400 degrees, and these babies are going in there for 25 to 28 minutes. After that 25 to 28 minutes in the oven, you're gonna take them out, plate them, and this is one of my favorite parts. I'm gonna drizzle some balsamic glaze all over these. Ugh, it's so satisfying. Okay, so realistically, use any herb that you want, but when you are talking about caprese, a lot of people definitely know that that basil flavor or even like a basil pesto would go really well with this dish. I don't know why I said oregano in the first place, but that would probably also work. I hope you try this dish at home. It's easy, it's healthy, and it's cheesy, which is like one of my favorite things. Okay, it's actually like my favorite food is cheese. Have a cheesy day. Thank you for watching and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more.